If you guys would like to pick up either of the figures you see in today's video, guys, go over to ringsidecollectibles.com, use the promo code MBTOYS and save yourselves 10%, as well as pre-order tons and tons of other amazing WWE or wrestling action figures. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today I have your 2-in-1 WWE Elite Series 69 Miz and Rey Mysterio figure review for you guys. Yes, we are down to the last two figures in Elite Series 69. I know it took us a minute to get through all of them, but we had other videos to, you know, we had action figure surgery, we had some other things coming up, and I wanted to make sure to get those figure videos out. We also had SDCC keeping us busy and stuff, so I wanted to, you know, delay the reviews a little bit, put some space in between them, and here we are on the last one. Don't forget, also in this video, we're going to be breaking down the whole series, ranking them from best to worst or worst to best, whatever the case. It will be worst to best. I'll start with the one I like the least and working my way up the ladder there. But anyways, looking at these two guys, I'm very excited for them. You guys know that I did purchase two sets, so you guys have already seen these out of the pack. Well, you haven't seen the Miz. You've seen Rey Mysterio because we did some surgery on it, but today we're going to do an in-depth review of both figures, and let's just shut the hell up and get started with the review, shall we? So spinning it to the right as we always do, guys, we got the beautiful looking pieces of Miz and Rey Mysterio here. On the back, you have more images of the two here and here. You also have a read-up. If you'd like to read it, you can go ahead and pause it now if it's not blurry as hell. You have the rest of the figures in the wave. Spinning it some more, you have the Miz and Rey Mysterio name on the side, and that is it for the packaging, guys. You have the front viewing window, of course, interchangeable hands, little bitty accessories here and there. And with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and crack these hoes at, oh my god, look at Rey Mysterio. He literally looks like Mysterio, guys. Look at him. He looks like Mysterio. He has the bowl on his head. He's just missing his signature cape. Let's just shut the hell up and continue the review. So here's the Miz and Rey Mysterio out of their packaging, guys. Looking pretty freaking well. You know, I did already unbox them, but at first glance, you know, just looking at them in the packaging, feeling them right out of the packaging in the hand, they feel really good, especially the Rey Mysterio, man. It's really hard to explain unless you own one of these newer Rey Mysterio figures, but anyone who owns them will tell you how great they feel. Like, they have really tight joints. They pose really well. They're just fun to play around with because they're so poseable. They have really good joints, and it's hard to explain. So if you don't own one, guys, go over to Ringside Collectibles, use the promo code MDTOYS, grab one of those Rey Mysterios, not the ones with the pants, but one of these, this one or the Elite Series 67. They freaking feel so good, man. I highly recommend them anyways, but let's go ahead and dive right in, guys. I guess what we can do is start off with the Miz. We'll go through the Miz's accessories and then take a closer look at the Miz, and then we'll come back, look at Rey Mysterio's accessories, and then look at Rey Mysterio, and then once we've wrapped up both, we will rank Elite Series 69 from worst to best. All right, guys, so starting off with the Miz's accessories, they always do this, man. They always include this oversized plastic ball of garbage with the Miz, and it looks fine on display, I guess, but you will not be able to move this man's arms. A lot of people I know cut the sleeves off of these and try to make them poseable as best they can, but, I mean, they look great. They're sculpted great. They're painted up great and everything. They're just really a big bundle of plastic, and they really hinder the articulation so much that I never end up using them. They always do this with it. They did it with the Elite 59 Miz. They did it with a couple other Mizes, I'm pretty sure. And they do it with some other guys. And I don't ever understand why we get these. I'd rather just have the headband, the glasses. But I guess I understand they're trying to include some accessories with this guy. And I guess that makes sense. But at the same time, I really just, I don't ever use them. So I wanted to make that a point there. I really love the headband that we're getting right here. This is his attire based on WrestleMania 34, where he took on Seth Rollins and Finn Balor for the Intercontinental Championship. He, of course, did lose that matchup, and he is rocking the red headband here. He's got the Miz logo right there, and this is a really nice thing. It goes on the figure very well as well, and we also have these glasses, which I don't think we've ever seen before. They're the same glasses he wasn't wearing these, I don't think, at that show, but he did wear them at Backlash, maybe, or maybe another show, but there's the glasses right there, or maybe he did wear these at Mania, and the picture on the back of the box for the Miz is from a different night. I'm not sure, but then we also include the Yes, Yes, Yes hands from when he used to mock Daniel Bryan. I'm sure he still mocks Daniel Bryan, but we haven't really seen the Miz in the ring in a little bit, so you know, he calls them the It Kicks instead of the Yes Kicks, so there is that. I'm really glad we got this. And he does point during his entrance as well, so you could say that this is his pointing fingers as well. You know, he points when he comes out, when he gets on the turnbuckle and stuff like that, so you could say that as well. So that serves a dual purpose. But besides all of that, guys, that is pretty much it for the Miz's accessories. So now that we have taken a closer look at that, let's take a closer look at The Miz himself. So take a closer look at The Miz himself, guys. We're starting off at the top of the head, and I really do like this head scan. I think it does look like The Miz a lot. A lot of people say that this is the best Miz head scan to date, and I think I can agree with them. It's a better take on the Elite 37 Miz head scan, which I used to think was the best Miz head scan, and this has the true effects applied to it. You know, they got his eyebrows right, the hair color's a lot more accurate, he's got his facial hair on there, and it's just a really strong head scan, man. I really do enjoy it. I like this body mold for Miz. One of the only guys that I think can pull off this body mold is The Miz, so I like this a lot. I mean, if they use the Bo Dallas torso, I wouldn't be upset, but I think this works for Miz for some reason. I just really like it. The arm choice is perfect. I really like this attire as well. It's the red and gold, or the Iron Man attire is what I used to call it, and it looks good. It's a different take on a red. It's not like oversaturated and stuff. It's like an off-color red, and it looks really, really good. You got his knee pads. That's the second or third Miz figure in a row where they've colored his lower legs in the black color, and I like that. You know, it kind of gives it that more kick pad look instead of, you know, just skin there, so I like that. And then going down into the kick pads, you have the same stuff going on. I swear to God, he's had the same attire for, like, many, many figures in a row now, and they just changed the color. We've seen black, we've seen white, we've seen navy blue, and now we've seen red and gold, and it looks good nonetheless. It's just, it's very repetitive, but, you know, I can understand it. At least they gave us a new head sculpt here, and it looks really, really good. The hair especially looks really nice, so they did a good job there. But that is pretty much it for the Miz figure, man. It's not nothing too crazy, nothing too over the top, but it looks good nonetheless. But now that we have covered the Miz, guys, let's take a closer look at some other Miz Elite figure comparisons. So taking a closer look at some Miz Elite figure comparisons, guys, you can see the brand new Elite 69 in the middle. You have the Elite 59 here, the Elite 53 here, the Elite 11 here, and the Elite 9, if I'm not mistaken. It could be another Elite. I can't remember this series. I can't remember. But anyways, you can kind of see the different trunks we got going on. I know I'm missing a few. I know there's like a brown one. There's another one. The white one, the Elite 37 Miz, also missing that one. And I'm sure there's another one that I'm missing in here somewhere. But nonetheless, they look good up next to each other. You guys can kind of see what I was talking about. This is an Elite 37 Miz head scan on this figure, on this Elite 59. And you can kind of see the ties between. They did resculpt the hair. They changed the hair color. They got the facial expression a little bit better. And the true effects is applied. So I think they did a really good job updating that head scan and making it look more like the Miz. And I think this is my favorite Miz figure. Oh my God in heaven. I think this is my favorite Miz figure to date, guys. I really think it is. I almost freaking broke everything just then. How crazy was that? But anyways, that does it for your Elite Miz figure comparisons. So taking a closer look at Rey Mysterio's accessories, guys. Not too much to this guy. You do get the sleeveless shirt that we have seen many times with other figures. You know, we've seen it with Ryback and Shawn Michaels and Rey Mysterio. We've seen it with Goldust. We've seen it with just a bunch of different people. But anyways, he's got the Rey Mysterio shirt going on. He is wearing this on the back of the packaging, but it's not cut like this. It's like just a regular sleeveless shirt. You got the Greatest Mask of All Time logo on the back there, and you also get this clear stand, which is made for posing and stuff. I think you're supposed to port this somewhere, or maybe you port this in the bottom of the figure's foot, and then you clip this to something, and then he's supposed to be posed around. I don't like using them. I never freaking use this thing, and so I just put it in a bin where it rots till the end of time. And then we get some interchangeable hands, which are way too massive, but you know, they did come with interchangeable fists for his interchangeable open hands, but nonetheless, they do make them way too big. They don't mold them in the smaller arm mold. They didn't make a different hand mold, so it's the same as the regular size guys, and they got a sort of a Jack specific style thing going on where, you know, the hands are oversized for his body. But yeah, you do get interchangeable fists, and that is it for Rey Mysterio accessories, guys. But now that we've covered all of his accessories, let's take a closer look at Rey Mysterio himself. So taking a closer look at Rey Mysterio himself, guys, we got the same thing going on that we had with the Elite 67, where they used the newer Rey Mysterio head mold, like the one they used in the later series, but they used the torso and arms and shoulders of the older Rey Mysterio bodies. I know the Elite 32 Mysterio had the same getup, but they had the old Rey Mysterio head sculpt. Now they have the newer head sculpt on the older body, and it works from the neck down. It's just the head scan and the hands are too big. I think that the head isn't terrible, but I wish they would use the smaller. I think it would make the figure look a lot better. His head's not oversized or anything, but it is kind of, it's not too bad though. I'm not even gonna worry about that. But the hands are definitely too big. They definitely use too big of hands for Rey Mysterio here. And so I switched mine out on Action Figure Surgery. If you guys missed that, definitely go check that out. The last episode of WWE Action Figure Surgery, we fixed it up, made it look a whole lot better. better, but all of his tattoo details look incredible. They look really, really nice. I love all the tattoo work we got going on. I think this is supposed to be his greatest Royal Rumble attire, if I'm not mistaken. It says, pandemonium broke loose when the Master of the 619 squared off against Andrade in an epic 2 out of 3 falls match on the January 22nd, 2019 episode of SmackDown Live. I don't remember. I thought he wore this at the greatest Royal Rumble, except he didn't. He had like a shirt on as well with a big question mark on it, if I'm not mistaken. But I think this is the lower half of that figure or that attire. I could be wrong, but going around, I love the decal work on this. I love the green and white. I love that there's like a darker green on the legs. I don't know if you guys can tell on video because it's so light, but there's a darker green on the legs and then a lighter green on the inside with the white outline, with the black outline of the 619, man. Really ties off nice. And then you have his epic boots that I like a lot. You got some great details going on with 619, and you got some logos going on. Greatest mask of all time, Rey. And then on the other side, you get a Rey Mysterio logo with a crown. Black outsoles on the shoes slash boots. And, I mean, they look great, man. They did a great job on the Rey Mysterio. I really do enjoy it. I mean, once we switched out those hands on Action Figure Surgery, it really took this figure over the top. But that pretty much does it for your Rey Mysterio figure, guys. So now that we've covered Rey Mysterio, let's take a closer look at some Rey Mysterio Elite figure comparisons. So taking a look at some Elite Rey Mysterio figure comparisons, guys, you will see here we have the Elite Series 67, the Elite 11, I think. No, that's not the Elite 11, the Elite 9 or 5, I can't remember. The Ringside Exclusive Rey Mysterio, the Elite 21, the Elite 11, I think this is the Elite 11, who remembers? Elite 24 and Elite 15. So they used to pump out a Rey Mysterio every other action figure series, guys. We also have the Elite 1. This isn't every Elite Rey Mysterio in my collection. I think I have one of every single one. So this isn't all of them, but it's all the ones that I can fit on screen at the moment. But you guys will see what I'm talking about. This is the newer Rey Mysterio mold, and that's the head sculpt they use. And then this is the older Rey Mysterio body that and shoulders and arms. So they like used to use this mold for the torso and arms, which you can see here on the new figure. But then when they got to the later series or the medium series nowadays, they switched to a larger head with bigger shoulders and arms. And so they used the head sculpt for the newer one, but they didn't use the torso, arms, and torso. They used just the head from the newer stuff. So I don't know what they were thinking there. I don't know what like the reasoning behind that was. Maybe they thought the head sculpt was better later and the torso before was better. I'm not sure, but it's definitely interesting. It's definitely an interesting note, and I would love to know why they did that. But nonetheless, this is it for your Rey Mysterio Elite figure comparisons, guys. And now we are about to rank every figure in Elite Series 69 from worst to best. All right, guys, it is time to rank Elite Series 69 from worst to best. And I gotta be honest with you guys, it's really hard to rank this series considering it is probably the best set of all time when you look at it from top to bottom. There's a lot of first-time figures in here. There's a lot of re-releases in this line, but there's also improvements in this line, which makes it very hard to judge. But anyways, guys, let's get into my top six right here, starting out with the worst figure in the wave. And this doesn't mean that it's the worst figure, because I actually like every single figure in this wave. It was really, really hard to narrow it down here. But starting off at the bottom, guys, coming in at six, guys, we have The Miz. And I know this is kind of dumb, because I really didn't want to rank it last. I didn't want to rank any of these figures last, but one of the figures had to go here, and I based it off of accessories as well. It is a pretty much perfect figure from head to toe. But when you look at the accessories, when you look at the big rubber piece they give us, you know, it's kind of frustrating. I don't like it about that, and that really bothers me a lot. So I went with The Miz here at the bottom, and it hurts me to say, but, you know, I had to go here. So Miz is in sixth place. Moving up a notch, guys, it was very close. It was, like, super-duper close for this next spot, but ultimately I went with Bobby Lashley, and it's kind of unfair because it's really unfair, sort of, but, I mean, I really do like this figure a lot, but it did have the large knee pads on there, but they are accurate, and you do get a slew of accessories. It was just really tough. I just couldn't put Mustafa Ali below Bobby Lashley, so that leads me to my next figure, guys. The next figure is Mustafa Ali, and I honestly wanted to put this figure at the bottom, but I didn't think it would be fair again, because this figure is so nice, and I know it's first time in the line, and it looks good and everything, but I felt that the head scan was too big. This figure would be higher on the list, but they made the head scan too big, but it also has badass accessories, and it looks great as well, so I had to put it at number four, but I really did want to put it dead last, guys, but I love Mustafa Ali so much, and we finally got a figure of him, and it looks good. It looks good enough to be at the number four spot, but it could not crack the top three, which leads me to number three, which is Rey Mysterio. And to be honest with you guys, after you switch the hands out of this thing, it moves up the list probably. I'm not going to lie to you. It does move up the list just a little bit, but right here, standalone, it is still a great figure, and I cannot get the fix up out of my head. Let's go ahead and bring the fix up over, because I want you guys to be able to see what I'm talking about. Look how much better this looks with the hands interchanged. It just looks so good with the white gloves. It makes the figure pop off more. It just ties in better, and it's ultimately a way better figure with that. So I had to put Rey Mysterio at number 3. Coming in at number 2, guys, I went with Tommaso Ciampa. Tommaso Ciampa does look great, especially when you interchange the Bobby Roode legs. It's just an unstoppable figure. Really fun to play around with. It looks great from head to toe. I'm so glad we got the good torso for this guy. We also get the logo on the butt. We get the knee brace. You get the camo pants. All that's missing is his shirt, which isn't a big deal. There's so many custom shirt makers nowadays. It's so easy to get. So there is Ciampa at number 2. And ultimately, that leaves the top spot to none other than Mr. Ricochet. And I think a lot of people will have this figure at the top of their list because it's Ricochet, first of all. Second of all, it looks great. It's a great head scan. The torso looks fantastic. They didn't go with a smaller torso. They gave him the ripped up torso. A newer torso at that. He's got all his tattoos here. He looks great. His height is a problem, but after you fix that, I mean, it's just immaculate. So I had to go with my boy Ricochet at the top, but this Elite line is so fantastic, guys. It's super freaking great, and if you don't own any of them, you definitely need to go grab some over at Ringside Collectibles using the promo code MDTOYS. But that does it for my ranking of Elite Series 69 from worst to best. But that does about do it for this 2-in-1 Elite Series 69 review on Rey Mysterio and The Miz, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy and you enjoyed the ranking of Elite Series 69. I would love to know your own ranking down below. Which figure is the best in the set? Which one did you not like the most out of this set? I would love to know down in the comment section below. If you would like to pick up any of the figures you see in this wave, guys, go over to ringsidecollectibles.com. Use the promo code MDTOYS to save 10%, as well as other pre-orders such as Elite 70, Elite 71, the Ultimate Edition Series 3 featuring Triple H and Finn Balor. Tons of great figures. I went and ordered my Ziggler and Finn Balor yesterday on Ringside Collectibles, and I cannot wait for those, man. They're going to be freaking fantastic. So you use that, you get priority shipping, you use the promo code. It does help out a lot with the price, guys, and it's a really good deal on some really amazing figures. Overall, I really do like these figures, guys. You guys know I also did the fix-ups. We fixed up the Rey Mysterio. If you have those white gloves, you can really make the figure even better. The Miz is a great figure standalone. Even though it came in the worst in the series, that's just because of the accessory. Even though you get a lot more accessories with that, you get the pointing hands, you get other things. It's a great figure. Also, my figure's legs are a bit warped, as you guys see, which I'll have to fix that later on. But that pretty much does it for this 2-in-1 figure review, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys. Also, earlier this morning, we posted my top figures of the year of 2019 thus far. You definitely need to check that video out if you haven't already. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.